This is your clothing, textile industry, car industry. Thousands and thousands of industry is used from the fibre. One thing I notice is people always say, oh, you can build rope out of it. Oh, hey, you can build cars with it. You can build this without it. You can do this with it. It's like, how? You've missed the most fundamental point, and it is a processing facility. Without somewhere to take it, don't even put it in the ground, because you're going to waste your money. If we haven't got a processing facility, we haven't got an industry. It is a heartbeat of an industry. Farmers bring it to the processing plant. Then from the processing plant, we can distribute to builders. Without it, we have no industry. And that's something that I think really skips over people's head. We need a processing facility in every shire, in every region, because you do not want to be carting hemp, because it's a lightweight material and you're actually carting air, but it has to start somewhere, and that's the processing facility. We want the stem. So what the machine's doing is cutting into 600mm billets so we can process it easier for the machinery we have. As you'll see, it's all laid on the ground. We'll come back in 2 weeks and flip it over with nature's little goodies. We'll start taking all the lignins and bacteria out of it, and that basically loosens all the fibre. And that will be letting nature do the ready process, and that's the breakdown of the fibre and the lignins and the bacteria to be able to, when we take that to the processing facility, to be able to come off a lot easier like that, and to be able to roll bale. Now, as a strong natural fibre, if we try twist that, that cannot break. So where we're building the houses out of is your inner core, it's called the hemp herd. Put it through the machinery, which will strip off all the fibre, and then we'll use the hemp herd for the building material. It's milled up to about up to 25mm. We've been playing with a lot of different building grade herd mixes. Then that'll be shipped off or bulk bagged to site, where we'll then put it into a mix, and we'll mix it with our water and lime, and then that'll form hempcrete. You've already seen farmers today looking over the fence. This is scalable, what we've done. For a farmer to be able to build something like this in a shed like this, we've got an industry. And I can't produce enough hemp to build all the houses at the moment. So what I've set up here is a square bale, roll bale system, where it can be your one-stop shop of bringing the fibre. So a decorticator is a series of rollers where you will put the stem through that way, and it'll crush it, then produce the long fibre, which will then take all this and just fluff it all up for us, which will basically flick out a bit more of the herd. So this is part of our separation system, being able to separate from the fibre of the herd. So all the raw product will go up into this system. The fibre will come out the other end, and out this end will be your dust, your fines, and your herd. So everything's going to be sorted out. Then that'll be separated. Out of here comes your herd. That's the building industry and the pet bedding industry. We identified that as being the main source of our income. Now, to make this processing viable, we have to find other markets. So what we can do then, through cyclones up on the roof, and the big dust tower will be pulling off down the other end to be able to get 4 to 5 different products out of this whole system, which once would have been waste. Now, there's no such thing as waste, it's a product. So you'll get out of the dust the smaller fluffy fibre, which then can produce amazing results of holding moisture. It's such a hygroscopic material. Now, this crude, what we call, it holds about 70% moisture, which will then go in up to your oil spills and nappies, bandages, medical, you know, you instead of replacing cotton, you can start to replace that because antimicrobial and antibacterial. Then you also, your fines will be going into a hemp-based render. Then you've also then got your absolute all fines as well, go into your 3D printing, your bioplastics and everything like into your palletization, which can then go into your chipboards to make actually a more sustainable building. You could add your insulation, your floorboards, your walls. You actually can make the whole house out of hemp, and we don't have to burn it. Because on a worldwide scale, people are burning stubble. So if we've set this system up, this first part, not only a fibre industry, but the value add to the farmer, it's about using the whole plant utilisation.